Tonight, Congressman Ruiz warns that we could be on the cusp of a major surge of coronavirus and another shutdown. I spoke with him from Washington today about this and other issues, including police reform. Congressman Ruiz, thanks for joining us.
It's good to be here.
Tell us about what's happening right now in terms of proposing legislation for police reform.
Well, everybody was dismayed by the images of George Floyd's killing, and we took the urgency of now to work with the community to come up with some solutions that will help reduce the racially targeted excessive use of force by police officers who do not follow their own code of conduct in proposing some solutions. And so the George Floyd Justice and Policing Act would do things like ban the use of chokeholds, that would encourage the use of body cameras, that would create a national registry to report repeat offenders of misconducts and racial profiling and excessive use of force in order to really prevent those that have disregard for their own code of conduct from moving from one police department to another. So that's the bill that we're going to be voting for, and I believe it's going to make a big difference.
Palm Springs Mayor Pro Tem Christy Holstage wrote a letter to the County Board of Supervisors recently saying that the Coachella Valley has a long history of racist policies and racist policing. Do you agree with her?
You know, I think that we have to be a little more specific. I think that what happened in Palm Springs under Section 14, where the African-American community and the tribe were relocated for development purposes, I think that was very specifically a racist structural change that needs to be rectified with the Black and with the tribal community. So you have to look at very specific things and to point it.
You just mentioned Section 14 and what happened several decades ago. That happened with Mayor Frank Bogert at the time. There are now calls, more than 1,000 signatures on a petition to remove his statue in Palm Springs. Do you agree with that?
You know, I think that that's something to consider. I think the community of Palm Springs, the elected officials, and should take this opportunity to really dig deeper into the symbolism of that statue for people in our community. You know, history is experienced differently by different folks, but everybody has the right to express their concerns and what these symbols mean and represent to them. And everybody should have these conversations, as difficult as they are. And so it will be up to the community to decide with their elected officials, with the city administration, as to the decision regarding this one statue.
Switching gears now, let's talk about coronavirus. Cases continue to climb throughout California and here in the Coachella Valley. I've spoken with doctors at all the local hospitals. They're concerned by the hospitalization rate going up. Do you think that we are potentially facing another shutdown or a second surge of this virus?
You know, I'm very concerned that we're at the cusp of another surge, and this one will is getting closer to the hospital capacity of our healthcare system to handle the surge than the first time that it went up at this rapid rate. So let's take a step back and understand that we only have two tools that are effective in reducing the transmission. The first tool is wearing a mask in public and when you're near other people. That blocks the spit from your mouth from transmitting the virus airborne to other people. The second thing that we have is social distancing. And so if we reflect back, what has transpired over the last several weeks? One is the rescinding the order of using masks out in public in our county. And two is the removing the stay-at-home orders, in my opinion, too aggressively and too early without the proper safeguards to control the virus, enough contact tracers and an efficient system to help encourage people to self-isolate if they can't do it at home away from their families. And we've also had a lot of public gatherings during the holidays as well as the protests without the proper, for some, without the proper masks or social distancing. So we have to go back to the basics and really encourage people. One, if you don't need to be outside and aggregate in public, please stay at home. Two, if you're going to go outside and shop and do essential errands, then please wear a mask. And then finally, if you're outside, keep your distance 6 or 8 feet from people and wash your hands. You know, Peter, this is one of the most dangerous times of this pandemic because people are feeling fatigued about staying at home. And they want hope. They want to go back to their previous routines. At the same time, where the risk of getting infected is going up because these businesses are opening, people are going outside more, and so there's more frequent contact with other people who may be infected without showing signs of symptoms. Therefore, we need to have discipline and understand that because the risk of infection is going up, we need to be more vigilant, more cautious, washing our hands more, and wearing our masks to prevent the spread of this virus.
So let me ask you, Congressman, do you think there could be another shutdown?
You know, I'm very concerned that there could be another shutdown or a more strict stay-at-home policies. If you open the economy the wrong way, you're going to have more people losing their lives without the safeguards and the contact tracers, which we didn't have in place. You're going to not be able to control the spread, and you're going to have lack of confidence in our businesses and our economy and having to shut down our businesses over and over, which will hurt our recovery and hurt our businesses in the long run. The right way of opening is to ensure that you have all the contact tracers apparatus in place, the containment phase, running efficiently, rapidly, turning around tests, turning around people to isolate them if they can't self-isolate from their family, encouraging them to do so with hotel rooms and shelters and social support as well. That will help build resiliency in the business, confidence in our economy, and they won't have to shut down. But unfortunately, we're at a phase where we're at the cusp of, because we didn't do it the right way and not having the safeguards in place to be able to control this, of having to shut down businesses and have people stay at home more. We don't want that. So this is the moment where we need to come together, practice personal responsibility, social responsibility, and do everything we can to avoid having to have the surge intervention and to help our healthcare system face another surge, overwhelming situation.
All right, Congressman, thank you for speaking with us.
Thank you.